Hi, hello everyone. This is Subiksha. In this session, we will see what is process creation in OES. So, first of all, what is process in general? It's some sequence of tasks which we will perform to get the desired output from the given input. This is what we call it as a process. Then, what might be the definition of process in OES? Yeah, execution of program by the process once the program is loaded into the memory. The lifespan of the process is actually shorter. As it reaches the end of the program, it gets terminated. So that's why the lifespan of the process is shorter. For example, look at the sample program. Here we are going to print the value of I. So here when it comes to first, we are initializing I is equals to 1. And whenever it comes to the printf statement, it OS tells the printer like be ready to print the passed value. And once the printer is done with this task, it passes the signal to operating system like I have completed the task. Then the OS terminates it. That is why it happens. Then here we are often, you mentioned the word program. So what does that word program means? To achieve our programming goal, we need to execute some set of instructions, right? These set of instructions has to be stored in a file. And this is what we call it as program. We'll write a set of instructions into a file to achieve our programming goal. And actually, the program is passive entity. Its nature is passive. And it will be stored on a disk. From this itself, we can infer that it requires only memory for storage. Okay, coming back to our topic, process creation. We have seen what is process, what is program, that and all, right? Then, what might be the process creation means? Obviously, from the word itself, we can understand that a process will be created. Actually, we can create many processes. So then how do we identify or differentiate a process? So to differentiate each process or to identify each process will be associated with PID, which is nothing but process identifier, and this PID will be assigned by operating system. And for creating process, we will use create process in Windows, whereas in Unix we will use fork. So whenever we create a process using a fork, the fork function is called, it creates two processes. One is parent process, another one is child process. Each and every child process has only one parent, but the vice versa is not true. That means a parent can have any number of children, but the child can have only one child, only one parent. That means here from this diagram, we can infer that there are three children for her. They have only one parent, that is she. She has three children. This is what we have said here. Like the parent can have any number of children, and the each and every child has only one parent. Okay, guys. Then process, that is children process, in turn can create its own children. You can just view it as a tree. Here you can see the parent of B and W is A, and you can see X and S parent is B, because B is the child of A and it's in turn creating its own children, that is X and S. Similarly, W, which is the child of A, it is creating its own child T and C. So it grows like a tree and is seen as a tree. So what is coming to the execution part, both parent and children can be executed simultaneously, or otherwise the parent will go to the wait mode till the children terminates. That is, the parent will be executed once the children terminates. Here we set a wait wait command, right? This wait command makes the process to wait for some time. That is what we say. Coming to next part, that is accessibility part. If the parent makes use of resources R1, R2, R3, the child can also make use of resources R1 and R2 because of inheritance. That is, children can make use of the files which its parent uses. Coming to, we said how do we create a process, how do we proceed with that fork command, and you might obviously think, how do we terminate a process? Actually, the termination occurs in two ways. One, first one is, once it reaches the end of the program, the signal will be sent to OS to destroy it. And the second, that is the other way of termination, is parent might terminate its own children execution, and the parent may survive for some other purpose. This kind of situation actually happens when the children's task, that is, when the children's tasks are no longer needed, or otherwise when the children's requires more resources than actually specified resources. As I mentioned earlier, like process lifespan is shorter as it terminates once the execution is completed. We can also make use of kill command for destroying the process manually. Here are the some examples so that you get a clear idea about what happens exactly in process creation. So here, actually, hello world will be printed 4 times, because as we mentioned earlier, whenever a process is created, 2 processes will be there. That is, one is parent process, another one is child process. Once this fork command will create, this is a command for creating a process, right? So one child process and the another parent process will be created. So you will get hello world 2 times printed. As you can see here, hello world for one for child and one for parent. Another time, we are creating another process using this command fork. Here also, similarly, it prints 2 times hello world. As you can see here, this is hello world, another one is hello world. One is for parent, another one is for child. So hope you understand. So totally 4 hello world commands have been printed. So here is the another example which includes 4 system calls, that is fork, wait, sleep and kill. Here you can see that PID the val is equals to fork command. So this fork function will return the process identifier. If the returned value is greater than 0, then that value is the ID of the process, that is child process, which shows that we are in the parent process. So here, val is greater than 0, we are getting. So it will execute the instructions inside this if condition. And the last statement of this if condition is kill command. So the process will be killed. And it comes to this statement, printf val. And the by will be printed in the output terminal, as you can see here, that is by. So for inside this if condition, it satisfies this condition, that is, it is divisible by 3. So we are making the operation that it should be added to the value passed, that we have passed the value 4533 as it is divisible. So we are adding by 3, so we'll get the output as 4536. And as the process is killed, and it comes to the print by statement, and the by is printed. And here you can see sleep of 15 command is there. This means that sleep command will make the processor inactive for some seconds. Like here, it will make inactive for 15 seconds, as we have mentioned here. So again, the cursor comes to here, first of C, then again this first function is called, and it comes here, PID val is equals to fork, and again in the similar manner, this fork function, will return the identify the what value has been returned, that is what PID. And again, similarly, here value is greater than zero and the instructions inside this if condition will be executed. So again, the value is 4533 will be divisible by 3. So it displays like performed addition operation as the number is divisible and it adds actually. And adds it, so it will get printed as 4536. And as earlier, it comes to this statement kill val of kill, and this kill command, the process will kill the process will be killed, and it comes to this statement printf by, and the by will be printed. Hope you enjoyed this session. I hope you understood what is process creation. Thank you all.